let us revise the previous class. Okay, in the last class we learned the properties of integers. Properties of integers. Now summarize the summary of properties of integer. So what are the properties, you know? So property closure, commutative, associative, identity, inverse, distributive property, property of one, and final one, property of zero. Okay, so first operation is addition. Just revise. Okay, which of the operations are satisfied under these properties? Okay, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, the first one, the closure. Let A and B be the two integers, then A plus B is satisfied. The given two integers are closure. So the properties is A plus B is also an integer. An integer. So it's hold. Holds good. Okay. So closure property holds in addition. And next one, subtraction also holds. A minus B is also an integer. An integer. So it's also holds good. And then multiplication. Let A and B be the two integers. Then multiplication of two integers, we get the integer. Is also an integer. So it's also whole good. And last one, division. Division, A divided by B is not whole in closure. Sometimes, for example, 4 divided by 2 hold it, is it? We get the integer. 2 by 4 is not a integer. Not a integer. So sometimes the closure property satisfy under the division. Okay. And next one, commutative property. Commutative property also hold in a addition. Is it? A plus B is equal to B plus A. Hold. And then subtraction is not hold. A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Is not hold. And then multiplication also hold. A multiplication B is equal to B multiplication A. Both having the same value. So it's also hold goods. Hold goods. And then here is not hold. A divided B is not equal to B divided by A. So not hold. Does not hold. Okay. And then associative property. Associative property of addition. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C is also hold. And then A minus B minus C is equal to A minus B minus C also hold. And multiplication, A cross B cross C is So subtraction is not hold. Subtraction is not hold because a minus b minus c is not equal to a minus b minus c. Okay. And next a cross b cross c is equal to a cross b cross c is hold and multiplication. And associative property does not hold in the division. A divided B divided C is not equal to A divide B divide C. So does not hold. Okay. And next identity. Identity only had the addition and multiplication. So additive identity. Which number? 0 is a additive identity of addition. Okay. So a plus 0 is equal to a. At the same time 0 plus a is also a. So additive identity is 0. Additive identity is hold. Here is not the. And multiplication identity is 1. So a into 1 is equal to a. Equal to 1 into a. So here also hold the multiplicative identity. Division is not there. Okay. And then inverse. Additive inverse. So A is a additive inverse is minus A is equal to 0. A is a additive inverse of minus A equal to minus A plus A also we get the value was 0. So it's hold here. Inverse is not here in subtraction, multiplication, the reciprocal. So A is a reciprocal of 1 by A. You get the value is 1. And reciprocal value of 1 by A is A. You get 1. Here hold. Division does not hold. Okay. And then distributive property only in your book given multiplication. Distributive property of multiplication under the addition. Okay. I hope you all understand the first 5 properties. Closure, commutative, associative, identity, inverse. So closure property sometimes not hold in division. Other operations are hold. And commutative property hold only addition and multiplication. And associative property also hold only addition and multiplication. And inverse also identity and inverse only hold in addition and multiplication. Now see the distributive property. So distributive property based on the multiplication. So A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. It satisfies the multiplication operation under the addition. Multiplication operation under the addition. Okay. And then properties of 1. Properties of 1. Let A be the integer. A plus 1 gives successor of a, is it? A oda one add panna we get the successor. Okay. And then next one, a minus 1 gives predecessor. Okay, predecessor of a lende one. For 4 minus 1, the predecessor of 3 we get it. Okay. So, and next property of 1 in multiplication, A into 1 we get A. It's also an integer. Here also hold. Okay. So, same number given. Here gives that same number. Same number. Okay. And then division. A divided by 1, we get the same value. Here also gives the same number. okay. So it's a property of one, hold in addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, okay. And next final one, property of zero. Property of zero, a plus zero, you get the same value, okay. Here a minus zero, you get the same value a. Here a into zero, we get zero, okay, it's not hold it. Here a divided by zero is not defined, not defined, okay. I hope you are all understand the properties of integers. Fill in the blanks. First one, minus 27 divided by 27. What we get? Minus 27 divided by 27, it cancels, minus 1. So minus 1. Okay, division of minus divided by plus value, we get the answer in negative value. Okay, and b dash divided by minus 125, we get the value of minus 1. So in this place should put in the positive value, then only we can get the value of negative in the result. So what is the value? 125. 125 divided by minus 125 will be cancelled, we get the 1. So plus divided by minus, we get the minus value. And c, 0, you can write directly, 0 divided by anything, any number divided by 0, we get the not defined. 0 divided by any number, we get the 0, okay. And d, minus 13 minus, here give it dash, is equal to 0. So here minus, so multiply in negative number, then only we get the positive value. Any two opposite value of the same number, we get the value as 0. Okay, so minus 13. So minus into minus plus. So minus 13, minus into minus plus 13. So two negative signs, two different signs are the same number, we get the value as 0. Okay, and next one, e. So minus 15 into 0. Any number multiplicated by 0, we get the value as 0. Okay, so 0 is equal to 0 into minus 15. And next, f, minus 3 into minus 6 equal to associative property. 3 integers are given, so multiplication of under the associative property application here. So 7 into minus 3 into minus 6 is given. In this side, 7 into minus 3 into which number here? Minus 6. Associative property. And second one, true or false? 0 multiplicated by any number, we get 0. It's true. Okay, and b, minus 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 2 is given. It's not correct, is it? Minus 3 minus 1, both having the same sign. So what we do, add and put the same sign. So minus 4 is the correct answer, but here given minus 2, so it's false. And c, minus 16 minus 0 is given. So minus 16 minus 0, we get the answer is minus 16, but here given 0, so wrong, the false. And d, minus 12 plus 12 equal to identity, we get the value of 0, is correct. True. And next E, minus 16 divided by 4. Minus 16 divided by 4. It cancels in 4 table. 4 fours are 16. So minus 4 is given. The given statement is correct. It's true. Minus 8 into minus 1 is equal to minus 8 is given. It's false. Because minus into minus plus 8 ones are 8. So given statement is false. Given statement is false. And third one. Calculate the following using suitable arrangements. Okay. Suitable arrangements. So first subdivision A, minus 142 plus minus 58 plus 200 is given. So here the both signs are same. So first preference to the these two values. So same sign, add and put the same sign. What we get? 200, is it? So already here one of the 200. So identity of two same numbers, we get the value was 0. So answer is 0. Okay. And next B, distributive property is given. 123 into 7 plus 123 into 3. So distributive property under the addition is given. So it's a both term having the same number, 123. So take outside 123. So what are the remaining terms? 7 plus 3. Okay. C problem is homework. Okay. And now move the fourth problem. An integer divided by minus 7 gives 9. Find that integer. So solution. Let A be the integer. Okay, let A be the integer. Then an integer divided by 7. So an integer by 7, it gives means equal to 9. So an integer, we get A divided by 7 equal to 9. So A is equal to divided by 7 is equal to 9. So cross multiply. So A equal to 7 9s are 63. Okay. 7 9s are 63. Here minus 7 is given. Okay. So answer is A is equal to minus 3. Minus 63. A is equal to minus 63 is the answer for fourth problem. Okay. And fifth one, give one example of the distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. Okay. Give one example. Let us consider the integers are A, B, C. Let's take any one of the value. Okay. So let A is equal to 3, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 6. Given one example of the distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. Okay. Multiplication over subtraction asking. Okay, so first write the distributive property. Multiplication over subtraction A into B minus C. Distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. So A into B minus C is equal to A into B. Distribute. So distribute. Okay. Minus A into C. Okay. So now substitute the value in this equation. Consider the left hand side. Okay. 3 into 4 minus 6. 3 into 4 minus 6, what we get? Minus 2. So minus 6 in a equation number 1. Right hand side. So 3 into 4 minus 3 into C value was 6. So 3 4s are 12 minus 3 6 are 18. So what is remain? 12. So different signs as usual. Subtract and put the greater number sign. Subtract we get value was 6. The greater number sign is negative. So it is denoted by equation number 2. From 1 and 2 we get A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C is verified. Okay, and then sixth problem. Find the integer which when multiplied with minus 1 gives minus 25. So let A be the integer. When multiply with minus 1. So an integer given. An integer multiply with minus 1 gives means equal to minus 25. Minus 25. So have considered the integer as A. So A into multiply with minus 1 equal to minus 25. Okay. So minus A is equal to minus 25. We need the A value. So here plus plus minus into minus will be changed to plus. So answer is 25. Thus an integer is 25. Thus an integer is 25. And seventh one. Determine the integer which when divided by minus 1 gives minus 47. Okay, so let A be the integer divided by. So an integer given, an integer divided by which number? Minus 1 gives. Gives means equal to minus 47 is given. So it can return as, so an integer be a divided by minus 1 is equal to minus 47. So a divided by minus 1 is equal to minus 47. So division move to the that side by using transpose method. So a equal to minus 47 into minus 1. So product of integer. Product of integers, minus into minus plus 47 into 1, 47. So an integer is 47. Thus an integer is 47. Third, C problem and worksheet. One, two, except VAT problem. Okay, so the first unit fully completed. What we learn in the first unit? In this chapter, we learn the basic operations of integers, addition and subtraction, multiplication, division of integers, and properties of integers. I hope you are all understand. Have any doubt, ask to me, I will explain. Thank you, students.